There is the course for the men's laser. It's the medal race. And to describe it for us, Peter Lester.
Now, windward lured, up down, sausage course. I expect we'll do three laps, and then there's this short little sprint to the finish as they come around that bottom mark gate. Three laps, three windward, three into the wind, three down the wind. Conditions, it's a sou'wester, 16 to 17 knots. We're on the Nauf course as we look down over the racetrack. The race committee are just shifting, actually, at the moment, shifting position. So the race management team just making sure they set the course to make it square to the wind as we take that lovely aerial view over the top of Portland Harbour, or Weymouth Harbour. It's a beautiful facility that it really houses the GBR Academy, where they come and train and race and learn the trade. That's the AP flag, that's the answering pennant. What that means in real terms is we're in delay. Unfortunately, first one we've seen this week. I think it'll only be a short delay. The race committee, I think there's been a bit of a wind shift, and due to the wind shift, race management team just shifting position and reconfiguring the racetrack.
Yeah, the buoy is being moved at the moment. 16 knots is the official, probably a little bit more than that. It's definitely moved a little bit further south. In that helicopter shot we saw, we also got the horizon, and I think there's some storm clouds building out there from the southwest.
I think there's storm clouds going to build on this racetrack when these lasers get underway with Slingsby. He's dominated this class. He really is a champion. He's won everything. When I look at his track record, he had a horror Olympics in Beijing. He was expected to win. He got 22nd. But since then, he's won the 2011, 2012, 2010, and he's just won everything. He is a champion. And can he convert it? You can be a world champion, but you've got to be the champion of the world in the week of the Olympics. And right now, Slingsby is on top. And he's really in the box seat.
Four-time world champion then, but he certainly will have that experience, and he will feel confident, because actual confidence is everything in situations like this. You can just see a little bit of white horse coming onto the sea there, which suggests that it is building. We've got 16 at the moment. It could gust up to 18, 19, 20 even as these storm clouds come in. There's Portland Bill at the top of the picture, the place where most of the stone for central London was taken from. It's Portland stone, very, very famous around the world. Chesil Beach, that long, long shingle beach that stretches 22 miles down the southern coast of Dorset. And it's a most magnificent vista, I have to say. When the sun's out, it looks like the Mediterranean. When the cloud covers, it feels like the North Pole. It's windy,
certainly,
and it's chilly.
Certainly earlier in the week when it was blue skies, it looks beautiful. But earlier in the week when it was raining and a bit gnarly, it didn't look too good. But it's a great sailing venue.
Peter Lester does not like the cold, ladies and gentlemen, I tell you. He's just a warm-blooded boy. And there's the beach. You wouldn't be lying out on there, Peter,
well,
I can tell
you. Look
how
many are swimming. Oh, there's no one swimming. I know, there's a couple of hardy souls.
Yeah, but they're watching the big screen there. So this is an area that's on the beach. And again, public access here. And the facility is set up beautifully. There's King George III there, just top left of your picture. The big statue of him. He used to come down here to take the waters and have a wonderful time. Victoria used to come down here as well.
They must have been pretty tough then, hardy souls.
Yeah, but they had these bathing machines. They could hide out for a long time before they actually put their foot in the water. It is chilly. Believe me, it is cool. If you're from Australia
or New Zealand.
Listen, you didn't even recognize your own flag.
I got tricked.
he saw his flag this time.
Oh, there's Jim Murdoch. That's Andrew Murdoch's father. He was just standing there in the foreground with a Kiwi flag. So it's great that Andrew Murdoch, who's in the race for New Zealand, currently in fifth position. His folks are here to watch. I'm sure lots of friends and family will be here
Well, he won one of the races. He won the fifth race, you know, and although he's had a couple of nasty ones, 17th in the third race.
There's the Aussie flag.
I've got it right this time.
The Australian flag.
You know why you didn't recognise the Australian flag before? You haven't seen it enough in
Rod
the games.
Rod Colour stars.
Yeah, enough of that. Okay.
Stars of the Southern Cross.
There you go. You see that they are having to change the...
Yeah, AP flag. That's the red and white flag. It's the answering pennant. A lot of the signals... is the we're getting close up goes the starting line flag.
LG3,
that same course, three laps up down, three windward legs, three downwind legs, and then the little sprint to the finish. And we are still looking at getting underway. We have a slight delay here in Weymouth to realign the course, but we will be back very shortly. Right, it is the Laser Men's Medal Round, and we had a quick look there at the committee boat as we overlook now Weymouth. It's the harbour side, the entrance to the harbour, and the beach absolutely full of people here at Weymouth. And just across the other side of the hill is the nose, where there they are, the spectators are absolutely geared up for this one. Now, it might be in Britain, but I tell you what, all the Aussies, all the guys that are supporting Australia will be excited by this one. Peter Lester will tell us why. Well, the Australians certainly are in the box seat at the moment with Tom Slingsby. He's on 25 points. Cyprus on 39, and that's a fabulous effort. Sweden, we just had the Swedish fans here. Is a migrant, he's on 60. So really, I look at the points, first and second is pretty tied up. There is a fight for the bronze medal between Sweden and Croatia, and I think we'll concentrate heavily on that top four.
Tell us about this red and white flag, Peter.
Well, it's the answering pennant, and a lot of the signals, or all the signals, in fact, in yacht racing are with the old naval flags. And you need to know those if you're a sailor. So that answering pennant just really says, well, we're in delay, to be quite blunt. When that flag comes down, when the race management team, John Parrish is the principal race officer today, flag comes down, there will be 1 minute signal, and then we will get in sequence with the warning signal at 5 and the preparatory signal at 4. There's another warning at 1 minute, and then we are into it.
Slingsby in the lead with 25 net points. He's had an extraordinary series. Four victories. He won the second, the eighth, ninth, and tenth. So he's come good when it really matters at the latter end of the regatta. So after 10 races, he leads. And double points are counted for the medal round, so it'll be double points here. The only guy that can catch him would be Pavlos Kontidis, but it would take a disaster from Slingsby, and it would take a brilliant performance from Kontidis to upset the form book.
5 minutes, as we thought, they'd get into rotation pretty quickly. That's the, well, we've got 4:50. The first minute is really standby, and the rules of the game start at 4. The course is set. It's 225 degrees to the top marks at Salwell. 16 knots has the ability to get a little bit more than that.
I think it will, because there is definitely cloud, although we've got sun out. And we see that the cloud on the right there as we go on board Tom Slingsby. He's looking good, and the Australians are looking for some really, really big performances.
Well, Slingsby, the Australians could be in for a big week. They've got a young team. Slingsby, 27-year-old. He's from Australia, of course.
And Warrumba.
Warrumba, and I think that's in Sydney, as I check. And certainly one of the legends. He really took over the mantle from Michael Blackburn, who was...
He's one of his coaches now.
Really, a legendary sailor. Laser sailor. He's one of his coaches, Victor Kovalenko, who's their national coach. He's just a coaching legend. So very well supported, Slingsby. Loves tennis, windsuit, cycling. A lot of the sailors, these laser sailors, have got into cycling as a bit of cross training. I understand Tom Slingsby is pretty handy at riding a road bike. As we look at Migrin, we see Slingsby right there, Migrin at the moment on his third. You can tell first, second and third before going into the middle race with the appropriate signage on the sails.
Well, he's also got listed here that is one of his heroes is Ben Ainslie. So with Ainslie, former laser sailor, of course, and champion in the laser, you couldn't ask for a better role model than that. Of course, he's already picked up a gold this Olympic Games already. But Slingsby, the clear favourite here. He doesn't have to sail unbelievably brilliantly to win it.
Bit of match racing going on here. Contenders chasing Slingsby. Is he going to try and get a penalty? This is all, the race has already started in terms of the competition between first and second. As Slingsby, Contenders just needs to be a little bit, he needs to be aggressive against Slingsby. But right now, if we were looking at classic match racing, coming up to 2:15, Slingsby in the trailing position would actually be in control in a match race. It is not a match race. It is a fleet race coming up to 2:05.
We're on the nose here in Weymouth, and that is a very, very big medal race we've got in front of us. The laser men's finishing race in Australia and Cyprus. They're the two boats that are fighting here. Tom Slingsby is from Australia. Pavlos Kontidis, and on the sail you've got the big map of Cyprus, of course. It's really strange. It's the only flag where the map is contained. And Kontidis himself has had two victories in the third and the fourth races. He's 14 points behind Slingsby, but of course with double points counting in the medal, it will be a really, really important one. He's got to win it, and Slingsby's got to be worse than seventh. I'm going to hand you over to Peter Lester now. We'll describe the start as we come up to 1 minute.
Well, Contenders, he has to beat Slingsby, and Slingsby needs to get down the back. I don't think that's going to happen by speed, and I just wondered whether Contenders is going to attack him in terms of pre-start. We can see small fleet, 10 boats. There's the start line between the two boats. Contenders holding Slingsby up. We've got 45 to go before the start. As we come in for the laser for men race. These boats are identical, supplied equipment. Oh, look at Slingsby. He's controlling there. The windward boat required to keep clear. So it's actually Slingsby at the moment that is the aggression at the back as Contenese comes around and tacks in the windward. Slingsby comes in underneath. 20 seconds to go, and the match race is on between first and second. It's Slingsby currently in first as Slingsby's just pushing, very aggressive. Back comes Contenese coming up here. 6 seconds to go. They won't want to be over the line. They look comfortably behind too. And at the gun, another clean start. And it is Goodison from GBR midline as they head off up to the first mark. And Costa from Uruguay got a nice start. Murdoch in there. And we saw that Contenese had to tack away immediately. First advantage there to Slingsby. Slingsby immediately tacks to go with him. So right now, they're 2-1 and 2 in the medal chase. Are trailing the fleet. It really has turned into a classical mud race. You watch the athleticism and how hard these laser sailors work. They just really pour it on. Very physical.
It's interesting the way that Contenese has gone off on the port tack and Slingsby is over him on that one. But there's a big difference in age, you know. 22 is Contenese and Slingsby is 27. That experience of 5 years at this level will make a huge difference.
Yeah, it does. And, you know, Slingsby has been the benchmark. We look at Contenese. He really is having a fabulous week because his consistency is not that high. 13th in Beijing, he got a 21 at the 2012 Laser World Championships in Germany, 10th in Perth in 2011. So in terms of pedigree, track record, it's all with Slingsby. But, you know, medal race, winner takes all. But Slingsby does have that buffer, John. You know, there's a decent buffer there.
Oh, it's a huge buffer. But just look at them out on their own with the jury
match
boat.
Race.
Yeah, the jury boat following.
Yeah, no issue upwind, though, in terms of the rules. Upwind, you can really hike and move the boat round. But, yes, the two that are in for the medals have headed off to the right-hand side.
They are. That's closer to the shore. These guys are still on their... the starboard tack, and they're all bunched up. The New Zealander there. Well, we'll see whether or not Andrew Murdoch, we saw his father, you recognised him in the crowd on the
news. Yeah, I saw Jim. Andrew certainly came into the regatta with huge expectation from New Zealand. He's currently fifth overall, and realistically, he cannot get up into a medal. He's had a couple of good individual races, a first and two thirds, but he's also got some high point scoring races in there, and I think that's the difference between Slingsby and Contenese and really the rest of the field, how consistent they are.
It's interesting that they're both very similar, so Slingsby yep. and Contenese, in terms of height and weight. It's 6 feet, that is 183 for Contenese and 82 kilos. And Slingsby is 83 kilos and he's just got another inch on top, so 186.
Here we go, meters. Cross. Here's the first cross coming up, and Contenese coming across. Slingsby is just bow forward. Tech.
That is really good.
Athletic.
We love that. And you can hear the crowd applauding on the nose. That is amazing.
All I can say is for those that have sailed lasers recreationally, they will appreciate how hard these guys work. It's a brutal boat to sail. You can see there's no aid on the side deck for comfort. It literally is a square gunwale.
One of the most popular boats in the world, though, Peter. Over 200,000 of them have been
amazing.
Made.
To show my age here, I did the very first Laser World in Bermuda, way back. And really, the class has just gone from strength to strength. It is the most popular monohull boat in the world, without a doubt. For the Olympics, supplied equipment by the regatta organisers. You turn up essentially with your sailing gear. You are allowed to bring your own tiller and the odd piece of rope, really. But apart from that, the sails, the mast, the boat, centreboard rudder, all supplied equipment. They are identical.
four-time world champion, Australian here, Tom Slingsby. They've taken a little tap difference, but look at this. The Cypriot really, really performing brilliantly. Just a little bit higher on the wind is the Australian. He'll pinch everything.
Yeah, but he's as fast as Slingsby, and Slingsby is lightning quick, especially on the upwind. But it's the work ethic. Look, they just use every bit of their six, both of the 6 foot. Here's second cross. It'll be Slingsby in a strong position. Liebau tack. It's actually Clara Liebau. So attack there. Gontadus tacks away. Now, tactically what's happened here is they've worked their way on port up towards the nose. That means the long tack to the top mark is starboard. Because I've spent so much on really going towards the nose, the long tack starboard and Slingsby mat tracing, you'll take Contadese all the way to the ley line. Once you're on the ley line, very difficult for the trailing boat to have a passing lane.
Exactly.
That's a close one. So there won't be a lot of ley line left on that right hand side. Umpires paying attention. So in terms of the rules, Contadese, as he comes on starboard, has starboard advantage. Slingsby required to keep clear, as he does. And then once the tack complete, the boat on the windward side, which in that case was Contadese, needed to tack away. But they're not worrying at all about the rest of the field, and that's reflected in the points. I mean, third at the moment is Nygren. He's on 60, and Contadese is on 39.
Yeah, you mentioned earlier, though, that they are actually fighting for bronze medal here. Nygren and Stipanovic.
Yeah, that's more important. So yeah. I'm sure at some stage we'll see them playing the same game.
There's Nygren and Stipanovic. They are playing exactly the same game. So we've got
two games.
Races.
That'll keep you busy. Get your calculator out.
What's this tracking
system on the
front?
That's what gives us our... That's a GPS unit. That's giving us the data when we bring up that graphic that talks about who's ahead of who. Now, the reason Contadese is just stayed in Slingsby's gas here is because they're very close to the ley line. Slingsby now... Out goes the main sheet, reaching. Look how hard the boom bang's on. And Slingsby will just drive that turbulent wind down onto the trailing boat.
Just describe this then. So the closer to the wind they get, obviously the tight
reaching
the
hard.
Has to be. They are reaching
hard. Yeah, see, they're coming into the top mark. But they're behind.
High.
No, but don't worry about that. Goodison's going to be first. But where the game's on is between those two, the Australian and the Cypriot. So at the first mark, we've got... We will have.
Looks like GBR.
Yeah, Goodison was first. Yeah. Paul Goodison, who won the gold, of course, in Beijing, but he hasn't been in the money here.
Andrew Murdoch is in the mix as well. There, look, right in the centre, and the French as well. So it's going to be very, very tight here. Jean-Baptiste Bernard gets round.
On the mark. That's a penalty there. that'll be costly. So that is. Here, look, Matt Trace. It's all Matt Tracing here. Contadese against. Against Slingsby, or Slingsby did a number on him there, made him luff up. The windward boat had to keep clear. We can see the penalty turn being performed by Guam. That was because of hitting the mark, but very subtle little move there by Slingsby at the top mark. Held Contadese up, luffed him. Contadese in the windward position was required to keep clear. That gave Slingsby just a couple of boat lengths.
So Juan Ignacio Magliaguero was the victim there of that touching from Mark. He had to put in a quick turn. And Slingsby, again, we've got match racing here.
Yeah, but the deal is if Slingsby can keep Contadese at the back of the pack, it's game over. And right now, the last and second to last, Slingsby's happy about that. See, forcing Contadese to tack away. So... Don't worry too much about where they are in relation to the fleet. It's more, can Contadese get a penalty or move up? He needs to beat Tom Slingsby by 7 places. The last and second to last. Right now, Slingsby's winning the game.
It's worth telling the viewers, obviously, if they're not sailing experts, they're just fleetingly surfing the channels, more or less. But we're in sailing at the moment, but we are concentrating on boats that are not actually in the lead in the race, but they are in the lead in the whole regatta competition.
Yeah, because the regatta is 10 races. The top 10 go through to a medal race, and it's double points. But the point situation means that we're seeing this sort of disjointed sort of a race being held. Tom Slingsby is 7 places ahead of Contades. And so what that means is, as long as he's ahead and Contades doesn't get up and get a high placing, he wins the gold medal. So tactically, they would have figured this out before the start. And Michael Blackburn, who's the coach of Tom Slingsby, would have had a game plan leading in. But you can see we've got the 1 and 2, the gold and the silver. They've gone over by the nose and they're playing their own game, John.
And Croatia and Sweden, and it looks like Croatia. With Stipanovic, could well put one over on Rasmus Mjergren, because there's only 1 point the difference. So by actually leading him at the moment, it looks like Stipanovic of Croatia will take the bronze.
Yeah, long way to go. We're only on the second leg as they come into the bottom mark gate. And penalty turn, that would have been a downwind penalty. Goodison, see the flag on the on the umpiring boat. So Goodison, it doesn't affect the medal standings, but Paul Goodison, who gold medalist from Beijing, has been penalised. Coming into the bottom mark, we concentrate on the gold and silver, and it is Slingsby ahead of Contades as they come smoking in from that right-hand side, jibing at the bottom mark.
Simon Grotelluschen is the leader at that second mark for Germany, after Goodison really upset the judges and got a penalty. But, we've had it before in the other laser radio race with women, where there was a little bit too much action for the jury to accept, pumping and rocking and really generally trying to get an unfair advantage.
So what the rule is, we call it rule 42 if you're on your computer, go and look it up on the ISAF rules, and essentially it's the rule that determines how much kinetic energy, how much rocking and pumping you're allowed to do, and it is restricted. They have tightened the game up. It used to be open slather, but in the laser class it is restricted. You can only pump or which means pull the sail in on the waves, or rock, and that's obvious, rocking the boat, to promote planing. And if the umpires, who have an interpretation on that rule, deem that you're doing too much, you get a penalty, and that's a basically one penalty turn.
Right in the middle of the picture, Tonči Stipanović, and he is attempting to beat the boat right behind. You can see in your picture, although they're a long way distant from each other, the camera really closes them up. Split, most beautiful part of Croatia he's from. That's where he's born. He was second in the World Championships in 2012. This year in Boltenhagen in Germany. The second in the World Cup as well in IR last year. So the Croatian really has quality, and he will give the guy from Sweden, Mjergren, a real run for his money. What's happening right here?
Yeah, still we've got the match race going on between the Australian, that is Tom Slingsby, and Pavlos Contades. And it is all Slingsby. He's winning the game. And I think probably there's Contades. He's being really, he's young. He's really, what a future he's got.
Yep, at 22 years old, you have to say that
he's going
to
be around.
Yep,
because to be honest, you look at Slingsby. I just wonder whether we might see him if he wins the gold medal.
Move up to Finn.
Maybe move on to the Finn. That seems to be the progression. We saw it with Ainsley, and with Ainsley getting out because he's getting a bit older, and he's achieved everything. I'm just looking ahead. I would see Slingsby moving into a Finn.
But with the way that Christian performed here, Christensen, he will want to come back to Denmark.
Yep, for sure. But we are in the medal race for the laser. It's all on between Australia and Cyprus for first and second. Big advantage in terms of the points to the Australian. But also on the water, Slingsby is dominating over Contades. But the game for the bronze medal certainly is strong between Sweden and Croatia. The race itself, Paul Goodison's leading, but he's got, they're going to leave him alone because he's back in the points. Disappointing result for Goodison.
Absolutely.
He came into this as at one of the big three for GBR, along with Ainsley and you know, and he hasn't performed. He's not in medal contention. This person is Tom Slingsby.
Yeah, well, he had 87 points after 10 races. The highest he managed was the second in the fourth race. Other than that, he had a discard of second race, which is 23rd. Disastrous, really. 10, 23, 16. You're not going to win anything.
No, you're not. He did hurt himself earlier in the week. He it sounds like he pulled a muscle in his back. And I'm sure that would have affected Paul Goodison. But through the season, to be honest, it has been Slingsby, who just has been dominant in terms of the results. Considine is the new boy on the block.
He's trying everything. He's trying everything.
And he's 22. He's physically, obviously, in great shape, as Considine's just had that look like the traveller. The boom runs on a rope traveller across the transom. So Contini's the block that runs on just got a little bit jammed there as Slingsby comes back to have another piece of him. Strong for the Australian.
Interesting. I've just been looking at his bio data, and our friend from Cyprus, Contini's, actually says his ambitions is to have his own yacht building company and to be a team member of the America's Cup campaign. You know a little bit about
Peter? Well, there you go. I mean, a lot of these sailors, you hear that common thread. The professional side of the game, there is a progression for these great young sailors. In fact, Slingsby, he's off to the America's Cup he's with Oracle.
You're going to be there as well, huh?
Well, I hope to be there as a commentator, and of course Ben Ainslie's off with Oracle as well. Oracle team led by Russell Coutts. Russell Coutts was also a very prominent laser sailor in his time, and I think I read in it was actually Ainslie's bio that Coots was one of his mentors. So, yeah, we will see these names popping up in the pro side.
This is a very familiar graphic now, because the one and two we saw with Ainslie and Christiansen in the Finn class, they were back at 9 and 10. What have we just seen?
Well, it's still the same. In fact, it's got a little bit more comfortable. But again, the reason is that we're in the medal race, and the sailors and their coaches have worked out very thoroughly it's about who beats who for the medals. So we're at that's the second upwind.
Yeah, it's a good one for the German too. That's Simon Grotelussen. And although it was Goodison that was at the the leeward mark first, and he's dropped back into third spot there. And who's that coming up from New Zealand? It's Andrew Murdoch.
Yeah, Murdoch's in there. So the GBR, France, Sweden in there next, and then Murdoch. Fair bit of chatter going then. Fans on the hill.
Because he's at Mergen, he's taken the Croatian.
Yep,
absolutely,
he's
brilliantly.
He's up there, so in third. So
Rasmus Mergen, is that the boy? Well, I will have a look at the time split, but Croatia's Tonči Stepanović must have really, really done something bad tactically there. Very, very poor.
We weren't on them. I just wonder if he actually didn't have a penalty on him. It could. I can hear a whistle. Let's. A whistle means a penalty against someone. I'm not sure who it is, but we go with Slingsby. I think he's broken the heart of Contides at the moment. He's certainly a lot further ahead than he was. Tom Slingsby from Australia.
The Croatian in the lead there, in front of them actually. Tonči Stepanović was 17 seconds behind the Swede, and there's the difference, 36 metres now. So 6th and 7th, but it looks like the Croatian is closing it down just a little bit. But the Swedish crowd on the nose really, really celebrating, and they know exactly what is happening with this race.
Well, for me, we're on the downwind. They come down to the bottom mark gate, up to the top, down to the finish. And it's starting to look pretty, I guess what I'm saying is we're starting to see a pattern, and I think we're starting to see the medalists. So Migrant, third, and he's ahead of Stepanović. So he is just hanging on for third for the bronze. Andrew Murdoch from New Zealand in there. Unfortunately, Murdoch not in medal contention. He's just racing really for pride. He's currently in fifth. but we're just concentrating on the medalists. And it is right now looking pretty good for Tom Slingsby for first. Second, Contides. Pavlos Contides, this young boy from Cyprus. Isn't it great how in the sport we're now starting to see these emerging nations? There's Croatia, especially in the Olympic disciplines.
But he's got the most perfect conditions over there in Cyprus, in the Mediterranean.
Beautiful, absolutely beautiful.
Everybody would like to
be in the
boat.
I wonder if he's got much competition, though. You know, that's the issue when you sail, when you're competing in a developing country.
Well, the great thing is, though, Peter, he's got huge support from his father, who encouraged him first. So, he'll be travelling as well.
Bottom mark. We're on the final beat to windward, almost. Coming into the bottom mark, it is
Germany
first.
Revolution.
As he comes around, he's comfortable, and then there is a bunch. We'll call it as they come in first.
GBR.
It is.
Oh no, France and Ukraine.
Ukraine, yeah. France. Then Sweden.
Is that Uruguay?
And it could be Uruguay, I think. GBR, Murdoch from New Zealand, then Croatia. So Sweden ahead of Croatia, the fighting for the third position. Then we wait. Here comes Slingsby. Currently lined up for gold, and there was a split, so it is Slingsby. He's dropped him.
Absolutely hammered him.
Slingsby
down there.
Another whistle. Those whistles, every time we hear a whistle, there's been a penalty. Someone's being called. I don't think it's one of the favoured group.
But the Cypriot was so close to Slingsby. I wouldn't mind betting that he had to take a penalty.
No, I don't think he did.
Really?
I don't think it was Slingsby. It might have been.
No, not Slingsby. It might. What I'm saying is it could have been Contides because he was suddenly.
Maybe. Although at the top there was a little bit of separation. We can just check. What did we have at the previous mark? 9 seconds. Stayed about 9 seconds, hasn't it? As we look at Contides. 10 seconds.
No, 15 seconds there, that last mark. So at the top mark.
Yeah, 15, and at the top mark it was
nine.
So no, that's not enough for a penalty. Contides, I think he's just. I think Slingsby's broken him. I really do. I think he's fought very hard, but Slingsby, tough Aussie, he's done the number on him.
We're talking a silver medal for a 22-year-old.
Pretty cool. Pretty amazing.
What?
It is an amazing, and watch out for the future. For this boy.
No, there's no
but
doubt
we're not
that.
Talking about the future. We're talking about London 2012, the laser class, and it is the Tom Slingsby show. He has gone through the week. He led going into this by 25 points. He had 25 points. Contides had 39. That's 7 places in the medal race. But Slingsby's tactic has been really to match race and make sure that he just locks the points away.
I think we're happy to say that Slingsby, barring an absolute disaster, is right in the middle of everything, but certainly favourite for the gold at the moment. But the big question mark is against Mirgren with Stepanovic, and here is Mirgren in the picture. There is just a second from the left as we look at that overview, and the Croatian Stepanovic is to the right. Who's in the lead here?
Yeah,
Peter?
Sweden are well in the lead, and he'll come across and tack it to windward. Put the cover, so it's Migrant, Sweden. Stepanovic from Croatia. And they work their way up towards the top, so we can see there's the cross. He's actually not going to bounce him. He's going to cover from the windward position. There's the gold and the silver. It's Slingsby. Slingsby's very safe now. Tom Slingsby, after 10 races, first position.
We had a little conversation earlier that you said GBR have had a really, really good decade of sailing. You think that Australia will probably be the next decade?
Next power base, I think. Wonderful result by Ben Ainslie yesterday, but that team's getting old, and Ainslie, even to his own admission at the end of the game, he's not sailing Finns anymore. But the Aussies are young. I mean, here we've got You know, Tom Slingsby, 27. He's in his prime. And then also in waiting, we've got the 49er class, Outridge, and in the 470 class with Belcher, and they're all young. So I think the GBR program is probably in need of a refresh. And sometimes, you know, your best asset becomes a bit of a liability as people get on a bit and get a bit older if you haven't refreshed your academy program. But I think this GBR program is amazing, really. It's so big. And new names will come to the fore once the likes of the Percys and the Ainsleys move on.
The voice of Peter Lester, who has made his life in sailing and has really been wonderful to get the inside track on everything here. It's just been a huge privilege to be with him. And we've got now the medal race of the Laser for men's. That's the final race. Points count for double. And there's no doubt at all that the Australians will be celebrating this one. Tom Slingsby is in control. Mergren going for the bronze medal at the moment. He's in third on his sail. You can see that's the number three there, pink. And he is controlling this one against the Croatian, Tonči Stipanović, who is really hoping, but I don't believe we'll get close because we don't have a huge amount left. Fifth mark coming up.
Yeah, up to the top mark and then down to the finish. The biggest risk, if we just talk about the Swede against the Croatian, is on the downwind, is keeping clean away from a penalty and of course, a boat handling error. In terms of gold and silver, that's it in front of us with Tom Slingsby. He's got it done and dusted. Even if he copped a penalty now with the Croatian, with Contides from Cyprus so far behind, it's really all over bar the shouting. And I guess, dare I say it, the opera singer's on the stage.
I think she is. And it's four wins and 3 seconds that's given her that confidence to sing.
And we know you can sing, John.
Oh, we're not going to make
it. I know, we're not going to. Contides, this young Cyprian, into the top mark for the final time in the Laser class. This is the medal race. First in, we've got Germany. But all action really is who's coming in next in terms of the medals. Uruguay, France, close at the front. There's Murdoch and Goodison from GBR. But it's the group behind that we're waiting for. None of the first boats in the race are in middle contention. So here's the first one.
He's done it.
He's done Mergren. Now, that looks like third. He went into the middle race in third position. It looks like he's going to hold that.
He's got a guy in between him as well. So from Guam, we had a little penalty against him earlier, but that is very impressive. Juan Anguero can do Mirkin a real favour here by keeping Tonči Stipanović away from a challenge.
And then we look at gold and silver, and that is, looks like our gold medalist. No rocking, no pumping. He's nothing. Just going to sit on the side and ride this one out. We're on the final leg of the Laser class here at London 2012. And this performance of Tom Slingsby, huge disappointment for him in Beijing. He went in as the favourite. The conditions were not right for him. It is his biggest disappointment in his life. I think he's lived through 4 years of having that monkey on his shoulder. He's about to get it off. Tom Slingsby is going to be, I think, Olympic champion. Pavlos Contides, he's the man of the future, without a doubt.
There is no doubt, but Slingsby was actually named the International Sailing Federation, the ISAF, Sailor of the Year in 2010.
Well,
so what confidence they had even 2 years ago.
Well, look at his track record, my goodness. In 2012, 2011, 2010, he's won everything. And this will be the icing on the cake. And I wouldn't mind betting that once Tom Slingsby goes over the line and we have the press conference tonight, that he talks about moving out of the Laser as Sweden. Well,
that's Brazil. Scheidt, of course, was one of the
I think
great,
some
great
of the sailors.
Sailors.
I didn't recognise them, but the sailors, of course, on their day off, sit up on the hill and watch their friends. There's great camaraderie in the field as Tom Slingsby goes down the last run to the finish. He is amazing. He required surgery after breaking his hand at training in 2006. That's about the only break that I can see he had. This year he rolled an ankle playing football with some of his friends back in May. So let's keep to yachting, Tom.
For sure.
Yeah, there's a few nuances that we read about, see, hear about, and of course these guys are really hugely respectful of each other. But there was a little bit of a fallout, I see here. Great Britain's Paul Goodison, who was the gold medalist in Beijing, he's now back in the pack here in Weymouth, but they fell out. Tom Slingsby and he haven't been talking a great deal since. So
there was a bit of aggro. Yeah. Look, I'm sure when this is all over, they were friends before, they'll be friends again. Coming in to the mark for the last time, now we're on the reach to the finish. It's Germany, Uruguay, France, GBR, that's Goodison, Andrew Murdoch from New Zealand, but they lead. That's the leading group. There's our first medalist.
That's the bronze.
That's bronze. And for Sweden and Rasmus Nygren, that's certainly, where did he get it? It lifts his performance from Beijing. He got sixth. But here is the regatta leader. Here is our Olympic champion for 2012 coming across the reach. We're just about at the finish. Coming into the finish of the medal race, it'll be Germany first, Uruguay.
That's it. So the German has won this. It's Simon Grotelusian. He takes it from Uruguay. And Goodison in third overall. But there he will be certainly behind as the Swedish guy comes across now. Rasmus Mirgen has taken the bronze medal. And I leave it to you, Peter, to describe the bottle of champagne opening.
Great moment for Tom Slingsby from Australia. Olympic champion. And next we will have Contades, the 22-year-old silver. Great effort. He's been beaten by a champion. There's Slingsby.
I love that, the way that he raised his hand and said, well done, mate, good on you, to the Cypriot. That was a wonderful little moment. He said, you pushed me all the way. But that is great celebration. They're the family.
That's right. I'm sure that looks like Mrs. Slingsby. Tom Slingsby overcome. He's been through 4 years of hell after being favourite in Beijing, but he's come here.
Well, all
dominated the field.
All together, then, he's put five wins together in his three second places. So an extraordinary performance by Tom Slingsby for Australia, and he picks up the gold medal. There's Pavlos Kontides, who himself had two wins, and he's had a couple of seconds now, being very consistent. He will be there to battle again, no doubt at all about that. And I think he's coming up even to have a little kiss to his friend.
Yeah, look, there's his coach. Happy. He should be very happy. And I think for the future, just park that name in the memory bank. I think Contades will be a sailor of the future. And to come second to the great Tom Slingsby, he's 5 years his junior. And he will have his time. I have no doubt he's got the physical attributes. He's tall. He's very athletic. And I think we will see wonderful things from the young Cypriot in the future.
Another little bit of trivia. In his early days, Tom Slingsby did not like sailing. His sister had to pay him money to race in his first session just to stay on the boat. He dropped tennis, sailing at the age of 15, and inspired by watching the great regattas in Sydney Harbour in 2000, and that's what gave him the lift. And that is what we hope, certainly all the British public will hope, that the young generation will be inspired. That is the confirmation of the results, and we have to wait until that actually happens, haven't we?
Interesting. There's a protest there. There's a protest next to the Swedish name, so I guess I think we have a winner, but I just wonder whether the silver medalist position, we might have to just call that a little bit provisional. I would hope there are no issues, but I did see protests there next to Sweden, and we won't know if there's going to be a hearing, but there is a question mark now between for the bronze medal, but no question mark for gold and silver, with Tom Slingsby, our Olympic champion.
And Conti is, of course, I mean, the number of medals that Cyprus would have won in the whole of the Olympics would be so, so limited. So they will be definitely celebrating in Limassol and in the whole of Cyprus itself. Limassol may be, it's going to be something very special for them. That is the medal race. Grotolution was the winner. Alejandro Folia Costa came in second. Goodison came in third. Murdoch from New Zealand in fourth place. And down the line, we look at Slingsby at ninth and Condidis at 10th. And that was the match race battle that decided ultimately this competition title. A gold medal to the Aussie. Well done, Tom Slingsby. You certainly deserve it. You were immense. And I know the tears of relief will be followed tonight by a big celebration. A big bottle of Aussie champagne, I'm sure. Slingsby from Contides. There is a protest against Mergren, but we'll see whether or not that is upheld. 72-77, that's the provisional situation. The gold, silver decided, bronze still to be debated, but it's been another magnificent day. Great, great medal race. And, well, fascinating all round for everyone here at Weymouth and Portland.
So Tom Slingsby just comes alongside his coach, and he will just compose himself. The emotion was running after the race. I think some of it is winning here in Weymouth, but also there's certainly some leftover baggage that now has been cleared off his back. Tom Slingsby wins the gold. Second goes to Pavlos Kontidis. Wonderful effort by this young Cypriot. Wonderful to see one of the developing, and well, it's not one of the traditional sailing countries. I think it's fabulous. Third place goes to Sweden. There is a question mark, but look, the body language is telling me that maybe that one is okay. Ramos Migrant, I think, is third.
The thumb is up, so it looks like it is. And there is the high five, and that is now confirmed. Third place overall. The protest was turned down. And there you have to feel there for Tonči Stepanović from Croatia, the boy from Split, and really didn't quite have enough. He comes in fourth place, the agonizing one, of course, at the Olympics. You don't get to the podium. You've done it. You've done well, but not quite well enough to pick up the medal. Weymouth Bay and Weymouth Beach has been stunning for all the competitors. I hope it continues as we say farewell to the boys and the Lasers. And, well, we hope that the racing continues this week, and you'll rejoin us later on for some more great, great racing from Weymouth. Australia.